So what we have here is your standard Sony Mega Storage 300 CD changer. This one's 300. They make them in all different sizes. Made them in all different sizes, I should say. And apparently one of the most common problems on this unit is this. Hear that noise? And lo and behold, it won't let me force it open. Let's see. There we go. So we hear the motor spinning, but the carousel isn't turning, and that almost certainly means a slipped belt. Now, I have never worked on one of these before, but I'm fairly confident that I can replace the belt. There's actually three belts in this unit, and unfortunately, I've got about 200 and some odd CDs in there, and I'm really hoping to find a way to replace the belts. Without having to take those CDs out. So, without any further ado, let's get this thing out of the rack and onto the workbench, and we'll see what we can figure out. Okay, so we got the thing on the workbench, and now we just need to get inside of it. There are several screws. These two on the top here. We got two on each side. Sorry, the camera won't focus. Two on the other side as well, and one, two, three on the back. So I'm going to put the camera down for a second and pause this while we go ahead and remove those screws. I think everybody here knows how to turn a screwdriver. Okay, so what we have here is a bit of a mess, and as you can see, this darn thing's almost three quarters full. After a quick precursory look around, the belts do not appear to be an obvious, easy-to-reach location, so I'm going to put the camera down for a while, have a beer, poke around in there, and see if we can figure out the easiest way to get at that without pulling all those CDs out. Well, a little bit of a lighting problem here, but I found where the belt is. This is the back of the unit, okay, and if we look down there, you can see behind that wire, there is a little white pulley, and camera's not picking it up, but the belt that was there is now laying at the floor of the unit, wrapped around the axle because it expanded too much and fell off. So that is the belt we have to replace to correct the turntable rotation, and as soon as I figure out how to get in there and do that without upsetting everything, we will have an answer. Oh boy, my camera's really struggling with the light level here. But I found the answer. The answer is this is the back of the unit, and we have to take off the back of the unit. And to do that, there's certain screws we need to remove. And again, with the light's a problem, but you need to remove one, two, three, four, five, six, seven screws. And once you do that, you come around the top here, and this ribbon cable, which goes up to the controls in the front and the display, we need to just unplug that from the circuit board. It just simply pulls straight out. Be careful with it. It's not terribly fragile, but it's not exactly stout either. And then down here at the bottom, there is, get the light in there, there is a single connector right here that goes to motors in the CD transport itself. So we're going to unplug that from the circuit board. Once those two cables are unplugged and those screws are removed, we can tip the back unit away, and lo and behold, we have access to the belt pulley and the old belt and everything. So, and without further ado, we're going to start replacing that. And you look, and you can see that one of the other belts is right next to it. So if we ordered all three belts for this thing, we got two of them right now. So I'm going to go ahead and replace these. It's just, you know, obvious. You take the old belt off, put the new one on. There's nothing to really remove that you have to get the belt around. So we're going to do that, and then going to continue on with this until we find that third belt. Whoops, it's upside down. Sorry, folks, I don't have a real camera. I'm using my phone. Anyway, those are the three belts. And those are actually, you notice two of them are the same. The top and bottom one are the same, and the middle one's a different size. I ordered actual Sony belts. There are generic aftermarket ones out there, and your mileage may vary with those. They may be as good, they might be better, but more likely than not, they're made with an inferior rubber compound that will degrade quicker, stretch out quicker, and leave you in the same boat as you are now. You know, we know that the Sony belts last 15 years, so let's go ahead with those again. All right, so I'm going to go put these two on here, which are the ones at the back, and then we'll worry about getting the one for the door up front in just a minute. Now, take a look. Oh boy, that got upside down again. Gee whiz. Now, take a look, or maybe I do now. Now, take a look at these two belts. The one on the right is the new one, and the one on the left is the old one that I just pulled out. They feel completely different. This one has really lost most of its elasticity. I can stretch it out, and you can watch as it very slowly and without very much force tries to return back to its original shape, whereas the new one is much stronger, much more rubber band-like, and immediately returns back to its shape with much more force. So this belt is just, you know, the rubber has degraded. One thing you have to make sure is that you're not getting grease on these, because sometimes the grease that they lube the gears with gets on the rubber and breaks it down over time. So before you put the new belt on, check the pulleys and make sure there's no grease on them. Okay, light problems notwithstanding here, those two belts are now replaced, and they are a lot stronger. So one of the couple things you want to make sure of as you put these on, number one, make sure that these pulleys don't have any grease on them. Make sure your cat isn't hungry. And make sure that the belt doesn't have any twists in it. Make sure that it's straight all the way around. You can spin the wheel a few times and check the entire length of the belt and make sure that there's no twists in it. If there are, take it off and put it back on again. You don't want to try and run it with twists in it. It'll pop off. Okay, now that we've got the two belts at the back put on, we're going to go ahead and reattach the back. Before you put all those screws in holding that back in, you need to reattach this little wire down here at the bottom first, because you won't be able to get to it once you do. So I'm just going to go ahead and reattach that little wire and put the camera down, put all this back together, and we will reconvene on the front of the unit. Well, I'm kind of bummed out, and I'm bummed out because it appears that the motor for the front door is actually under the turntable, which means the turntable is going to have to come out in order to service that belt. So after we put the back on, and before we put the back on, we reconnected that one cable at the bottom there going to the motors, and then afterwards I reconnected this ribbon cable. So this unit actually would work fine right now. The front belt, or the belt for the front door, hasn't slipped off yet. But seeing as how it's the same age as all the other belts, I know that's going to happen. I've got the other belt right here. So, you know, I have two choices. I can either go ahead and take this thing the rest of the way apart and do that other belt, or I can take the belt for the front door and I can tape it up inside here somewhere so that when it finally does go, I won't have lost it, and I'll be able to do that job then. I am going to go ahead and pull this thing the rest of the way apart so that we can do this and document it. And it's going to start almost certainly with pulling off this bracket, this wire loom shield here, these screws here, and probably the center pieces here. And then we're going to have to lift the entire turntable out without spilling the discs everywhere. So I'm going to give that a shot right now. Once I figure out how to do it, we'll come back here and explain it. Okay. It's pretty ugly, but not too bad. Basically, I should have not reconnected this ribbon cable because it's going to have to come off again. We are going to open this clip. And to the extent to which I can do this stuff with one hand, we'll see. That clip there, we're going to free that wire out of it, free this. There's another clip just like that here. It just snaps open. There's two little catches here that hold this, and all you have to do is just kind of tilt the ribbon to the side, and it comes out. Careful not to tear it. Be patient with that if you can't figure it out at first. And then this little bit of stickum here holding the ribbon on. Well, it's going to leave some of itself behind, so we'll know right where to attach it again, won't we? So that, and we're going to unplug this, what I assume to be those little fancy, dancy red, green, blue LEDs that give you a disco show as the discs rotate. Now, one thing I've done is I've noticed that my unit isn't completely full, and I've rotated this platter so that the open space is where this guy here is. The screws for this are on the underside. You can get to them, but it's easier just to, you know, find a spot of 10 or 12 open discs and rotate that to there. So, having said that, again, we're going to see how effectively I can do this with one hand, hold the camera, and talk. And take out that screw. And where's my little screw can? Well, I don't have a screw can, so we'll just put them inside a roll of tape. We got that off of there. We're going to take these two screws out. See how if you're ever wondering how to capture a screw with one hand, that's how you do it right before it comes out. Slide your hand down the shaft. Give it one little twist and you're done. Okay, so we got that. Okay, we'll set that bracket aside. And what else have we here? We've got this little plastic hood guy here. It attaches to the front, it appears, via two screws. So far, all the screws I've been removing here on this particular phase are the same type of screw, same size, so we can just mix them all together. As a general rule, if you're taking something apart and you start encountering different size screws, unless you're videoing it like I am, or you're, you know, got a photographic memory, you're going to want to sort them out somehow so that you don't mess up when you go to... see, there's a different screw. That's a nice long one. Well, I think it's pretty easy to remember that the long one goes right down the middle there. But say, for example, I were to put that long one back in the wrong place. If I were to do that, it might poke all the way through to something. And okay, well, that came out. There was probably something I should have done first, because I kind of felt it kind of rudely disengage from the front door. That is not just that upper support, but it apparently has a arc-shaped slide track that the door goes into. And if I look at that track, it looks like that notch there on the left is how you get the thing to enter and exit this piece when you want to remove it. I may have just done that inadvertently. I guess we'll find out when I go to reassemble it. So, how free is this thing now? Yep, perfect. So I can just grab this turntable in the center and lift it right out. And it doesn't even look like I have to take any discs out. We'll see here. No. Okay, what do we have going on here? We've got these two guys at the back here, and they're preventing me from easily tipping this out. So I'm going to try doing some whoopsie. And now I'm banging the discs into that little guide over there. Okay. This, I think, is rapidly approaching the limits. Ooh, that was horrible. Rapidly approaching the limits of what I can do with one hand, because I'm either catching back here or I'm catching up front. It looks like I'm going to have to take off a little more up front or a little more off back, out from the back here, and to do it without busting something, I'm going to have to put the camera down. So when I figure that out, we'll continue. Okay, it wasn't too bad. Basically, we're taking off the whole front here. There are three screws on the bottom. So what I did was I simply slid the unit forward off my workspace a little bit so that I could just unscrew the screws from the bottom without having to upset anything. So there's three on the bottom. Two of them are cleverly hidden inside little chambers of these little fake feet on the front. So there's one, two, and then there's a third one. Sorry about the lighting and the focus again. Third one in the middle here. And there's also a little plastic door that covers up the hole under there on the front. And it just kind of falls off when you start pulling things apart. So, you know, make sure you don't lose it, step on it, what have you. And over here on the side, on the left side by the headphone jack, there's a couple other things. We got to pull this little ground clip off, which is easy. There's a screw here, which I've got most of the way out. And there is a plug going to the keyboard jack, and we're gonna have to unplug that too before the face will come off. Let's see if I can manage that without putting the phone down. There we go. Fortunately, that was only my little inspection mirror that fell just then, and that was only my screwdriver. Cheers. Okay, so we're going to take out that last little screw that I just left finger tight, and there's these little plastic catches on the side here that you have to unhook, and on one on each side, although if you get the first one, the other one will probably just fall off by itself, as it just did. Okay, so trying not to drop anything with all I've got going on here. Okay, so there it is. The faceplate is now completely separated from the unit. There's the ribbon cable there, so we'll want to put this somewhere, set that aside where it can't get damaged, and of course, before we put everything back together, take this opportunity to get all the dust bunnies out of here. So, as I noted before, there's that little tab that has to go into this upper guide. So it turns out that I actually did just happen to have the door in exactly the right position for this to come apart. If I'd had this front door open even slightly, that would have not come apart like that. So before we take that top part off, we'll do what I just kind of lucked into, which is to make sure the door's closed. So now I think we can just slide this door off to the side here, and I should be able now, with all this clearance in the front, to just lift this thing out, although it is incredibly cumbersome and weighty with all those CDs. So let me once again put the camera down, but I'm pretty confident I should be able to wiggle it out now without having to drop anything. Alright, so now it turns out that the thing holding it back is this piece here. Because of this here, I have to have a gap where this is, right? Otherwise, I'm clearly not going to be able to lift the tray out. Well, similarly, this thing here is concave, and the CDs kind of fit into it. And if there are any CDs lined up with this whole piece of plastic, trying to lift it out just doesn't want to happen. Luckily, that's one screw here and then one screw way down there, but you can get to it with a long screwdriver quite easily, and if it's got a magnetic tip on it, it'll even pull it right out for you. So we're going to remove this, just two screws, and I think we're home free at that point. All right, well, who fucking Ray? We got the thing out. So here's what it wound up being. It indeed was this. Was the last piece of the puzzle that had to come out. And let me tell you, this would have been a lot easier had there not been any CDs in it. But then again, putting 200 and some CDs back in the correct slot isn't exactly quick either. So this guy had to come out, screw there, and then screw down at the foot of this going into the base there. These wires here went through that little twisty wire loom back and then passed through that hole. So you had to just very quickly free the wires up from that clip and that hole. And once you take out those two screws, you can pretty much wiggle this thing out. So, a couple things I noticed when removing the tray. It did come out fairly easy when I got it out, when I got this guide out. But, two things. Number one, it's heavy and awkward when the tray is loaded that way, all the weight at one side and off balance. It's kind of weird to hold it. And I actually did wind up spilling a couple CDs. Fortunately, only six of them, so that won't take me very long to correct. And none of them got scratched or broke. But what I found out when I removed the thing is that the bottom of the platter, which we won't show you because to do so would spill all the discs out, bottom of the platter has grease on it because it sits on this cone, which is its pivot point, and you can see it's all lubed up with white grease. So you have to have a place to put the platter down, which is relatively clean, because that grease will pick up dirt otherwise. So you can't see it over here, but I found a sheet of paper, 8x11 paper, and I slid it under there where all that grease is so that, you know, it's not going to pick up my cat hair off the floor, for example, and bring that back in there. Anyway, here is our belt, and now we can get to it. I have to say, after all this work, I was really hoping to find a belt that was more worn out than this. This one seems to be fairly, it doesn't feel like it's brand new, but it doesn't feel like it's about to fall off anytime soon. We're going to go ahead and replace it now, but I point that out because if you're sitting on the fence trying to decide if you want to do all this work to get to that belt before it even goes out while you're in here, you know, at least on my unit, it turns out that belt seems to be okay. Let's go ahead and put the next one on, the new one on there. It seems like it's just a matter of popping this one off. Let's see if it's the case. Yep, that's the case. There's no guide or anything holding on there. So here it is. That sucker feels pretty good. It snaps back quick. Here's the new one. Just put this camera like so. This must be terribly entertaining to watch this litany of bizarre camera angles. Here we go. This belt definitely, the new belt definitely feels better, and it kind of goes boing when you pull on it like that. You know, you could go either way. The old belt had definitely worn some, but in my opinion, it was still quite some time off from failure. Oh, so let's see if I can just manage to focus the camera. Let's see, I'll put the camera like this. And we'll make it focus. There we go. Now with my other hand, I will get in there. Hey, this is working. Except that the belt's bent in the wrong way. Try it like that. So I'm just trying to catch that pulley. Somehow out. Oh, so close. Over, under, over. There it is. Okay, so we want to try and, you know, see, I'm going to twist it with my fingers now and try and get all the twists out of it before I stretch it over the wheel. Or at least get them all out on one side so that as I rotate it around, now hopefully. Okay, I got it on there, and I saw a couple twists, but they were self-correcting, because as I turn it all the way around, it's straight, and the door is moving. Okay, that's it. So once we get the tray off, you don't have to pull the motor or anything. You can just slide the belt on, put it on there. You're good. So now we're just going to go through here with a rag, wet rag. Mop up some of this dust, get it out of these slide points, just do a general inspection, check out these gears now that we have access to the other side of them. You know, truth be told, those ones in the back there, the one on the left, which is the load eject mechanism for the actual transport, this one here, we could have done this one without taking off the back, it turns out now. The other one, it is tucked in there. I could see that was camera can't see. I could see. Camera can't. I could see that with slender fingers and maybe some tools, you could get that belt on from this side and save yourself the step of taking off the back that we did first. But compared to getting the platter out and all that, frankly, that was minor. So, I don't know. It could be done. That would be annoying, though. It would be annoying. You could do it, but it would be frustrating. That one there, the load of jack, you could easily do it while you're in here. So, food for thought. So, we'll inspect the gears, make sure none of them are dry, make sure no dust bunnies are pulled up into them. Do the same through here. And also, when you're looking at this grease, check for grease migration onto parts that really shouldn't be greased. That stuff does have a tendency to kind of creep around and isn't always necessarily applied with the greatest of care from the factory in the first place. After I inspect that, take a quick look back here. The power supply capacitors, they're hiding there behind the transformer. None of them are bulged. That's a very good sign. And yes, and there you go. So we'll do a little general cleanup in here, and then we'll start the process of reassembly. And we're back. So went ahead and put the turntable back in. One thing I noticed was this door here, you can slide it around manually, but don't push it all the way to the right, because if you do, something underneath there will poke some of these CDs up and make them get jammed and halfway in between their slots. And fortunately, a couple of those, I think I might have reseated them in the wrong slot. But for the most part, my goal of not getting these out of here, not taking all the CDs out, has been successful, other than the six that I spilled out before, which I still think is worth the effort. Anyway, so we're going to have to reattach the front, reattach the wire bridge, reattach the whatever you call this upper guide plastic piece. And I think actually in reassembly, even though we took this off before the front, I think in reassembly this might be better off going on first. I'm going to give that a try. Probably going to have to put the camera down to do it, but I'm going to try and reassemble this with this piece first. Okay, I've done that now. Literally, all I've done is put this on here, put that one big long screw down in the middle there, and remate the front door with this track. I believe that now I should be able to take the front piece sitting over here. I should be able to take that and push that straight on. I'm going to line it up, perfectly lined and straight with the front, and just push it on, because I think that's how these clips on the side here will accept it, and I think the whole thing is just going to go, right into place. Again, that's going to take two hands, and I don't have a stand for a phone, so we're going to put this on pause for a second. Well, I wish I'd had a third hand, because I could have showed you how easy that, in fact, was. Had to wiggle this a little bit to make it line up as I was pushing on the front. But that was easy. And the only other thing I had to check was to make sure that this little bracket on the side here overlapped. But basically, it did. It pushed straight on. So just line everything up and just push it straight forward, and boom. Now we just got to start putting everything back together. It's going to be the screws, then it's going to be the metal cable bridge, etc. I'll explain anything that goes funky during that process, and you'll see in just a second what that looks like. Okay, that also went quite easily. So what I've done now is I've reattached this metal cable bridge. Two screws here and here. One screw there, right? And, we're just going to lay these wires back into these clips and reattach those in a second. Other screws that go on. This screw joining here. This screw that's joining there. screw on the side here. Focus, please. Screw on the side here for this bracket. Then the little ground clip goes there. And PS2 keyboard input right there. And I'm going to take a second for the camera to see this. The screws on the bottom. One up there inside the foot. One there in the center. And it's kind of cheesy that Sony didn't black that out. And one down in that foot. And you can see here on the front, that little door, a little plastic door that came off when we removed the front panel, and it just kind of snaps into place. You'll see how it goes back in. Pretty simple. Wish they'd given us a black screw there. It's visible from the front. Annoying. All right, well, that was actually quite simple, so now we're going to reroute the cable. She's just going to twist it a little bit there. And easier to do when you're not trying to hold a phone, let me tell you. There we go. And through this clip. And we'll just put that tape right back where that was. This and this both go through that clip. I would assume that the lid would touch this and not the cable, because I think putting the cable on top of that would sandwich it between the lid, and that wouldn't be good. And this probably I should have paid more attention to the previous routing before I pulled it apart. Well, that's what video's for. So, well, that's a clue right there, isn't it? It needs to be tight because it plugs in here. Boy, this is difficult with one hand and a phone. Goodness. Now, okay. And the ribbon connector. Okay, let's take a look here. Yeah, that little foam block would, in fact, kind of sandwich the cable. So I think it's just better off to the side. I really don't think it was meant to be up on top of it. Kind of a rinky-dink situation there. You know, I think I know what I'll do. I got friction tape right here. I was using it to hold the screws. So, yes, I'm using my chin to hold the phone. You guessed right. Sorry, folks, thanks for bearing with me, but you get the idea. I just used a piece of friction tape there to keep this cable away from this little foam riser, which cushions weight that's placed on top, because we don't want this cable coming between the weight of whatever component gets placed on the cover of this thing and the foam, because it'll just grind this thing down eventually. All right. That's pretty much it. You know, one thing I should point out is, get the flashlight, it's down in here, this little pair of pincers here is what plucks the discs out of the tray and pulls them up into the mechanism and then puts them back. And there had been quite a buildup of gritty, sand-like particles in here. I guess there's some glue on that felt that, you know, cushions it, so to speak. And it got filled up with gritty things that I thought could easily scratch a disc. So I took the moment to clean that off. I also cleaned off quite a bit of dirt off of the spindle there, in there. Checked the laser, made sure it was clean. Didn't really have to do anything to the laser. The optics look fine. So that's pretty much it at this point. It's really just a question of testing it and putting the lid back on. So let's do that. Let's test it. Grab the... Oops, see, I got a rubber banded extension cord. There we go. Ooh, look at all those dust bunnies. Yowzer. Plug in. Okay. So we have power, let's turn it on. Let's see if I can hold the phone to where we can see the carousel and the front panel. Hey, the carousel's turning. As of course we knew it would. Oh, it's just gonna load a disc. And, well, it's working apparently. I didn't tell it to do anything. But I guess it was on disc 23 when it went out of service and decided that's where it wanted to pick up. So we'll tell it to stop. Well, it's already stopped, so let's tell it to open. See, will it put the disc back in? It does. And now it's spinning it around, and it's going to present me, in theory, with disc 23 lined up at the line, which, yes, phone, I know I have no battery, quit annoying me. So there's a little quote-unquote line there. That would actually make sense for me to paint that white, wouldn't it, while I'm in here. That's pretty much it. I think we just put the cover back on now to be... Yeah, it closes. Let's use the... This is a jog wheel. No, don't play it. Well, it's obviously in some... state. Either that or I just push play without realizing it. Alright, well, I'm ready to call this a success and put it back together. Well, once again, the light won't come on because my camera battery is low. But... it's working. All right, well, I hope I helped you out somehow.